Alicia. My artist name is Buppy Dogs, and I make illustrated goods about mental health. So I wanted to share a couple zines and do a little zine reading for you all today. These three are consecutive. It's like when you feel an incoming anxiety attack. This is during, and this is a little bit of aftercare, and then rinse and repeat. So let's read, and then at the very end I'm going to read my newest zine, Not Queer Enough. So let's slow down for incoming anxiety attacks. Can you take a step outside for a bit? Deeply breathe fresh air through your nose. Hold it a little longer. Exhale slowly. Place your hands on the area of your body that feels tense. Take a moment to be aware of the pressure building up. Maybe we can release with a big stretch. Before we jump into solving things, what do you need right now? You hold yourself like no one else can. In this moment, you are safe. I know the anxiety feels so overwhelming and real. It is really scary, I know. It's okay. It's okay to feel scared. I give you permission to feel these sensations and remind you that this pain will pass. You don't have to force anything to change. Your body knows how to release. What is so important is to try to slow down those racing thoughts. What do you need in this moment? Take your time. This is for anxiety and panic attacks. I'm here for you. It's okay. I know this hurts so much right now and you want to make sense of it. You don't have to figure it all out alone anymore. I'm here. Can you stay with me? If you get swept away again, you can come back to me. We will come back and attend to these difficult feelings. But for now, can you stay with me? Try to slow that breath. If nothing is working, can you find a place to just scream? Cry? Let it all out without being interrupted? I know it's really unbearable feeling this way, and it's only natural you want these feelings to go away. But I'm here to remind you that this is temporary. You are capable of surviving this. We don't have to add any extra meaning, analysis, or judgment right now. You don't have to believe any of these thoughts or feelings. We're going to take care of you first. And this one is personally my favorite right now. A letter to myself. Hey, little one. I wanted to let you know that everything you're going through makes sense. It's really understandable. When you're triggered, you develop the survival mechanism to protect yourself, to make sense of things when you had no idea what was going on. You didn't know how, but these were attempts to get what you needed. Emotional connection, safety, security, attention, and reassurance. And perhaps there wasn't much there to begin with. And yet, you were brave and tried in the best way you could. I know you're frustrated with yourself. Of course you would be. I wish I could give you all the answers you so desperately seek. But I can tell you this, even if it doesn't feel like it right now, you are on the right path. You have grown and improved more than you give yourself credit for. You couldn't get here without making those mistakes. Mistakes can be forgiven and understood. If you knew what to do, you would have done it, but you did the best that you could in that moment. I know you don't want this to happen again, so your mind believes it can prevent it by catastrophizing. Ironically, that very state sends you into more panic. and paranoia. I'm here to remind you that we can step out of that vicious cycle. You already are. You're doing just fine. And then my last one is not queer enough. This is one that I actually made a while ago. But I redid it last week. So for me, queerness is shedding layers I have internalized from my upbringing and environment. It's my attempt to feel safe in my own skin. Unbecoming, becoming. I've hesitated coming public with my queerness. I didn't want my entire identity encapsulated into one category. Not quite queer enough, not quite passing enough. Coming out can feel performative at times, not feeling enough in either facet. But I can show that this is what non-binary looks like, representing my own interpretation of gender fluidity and androgyny, outside heterocentric understanding. As I continue to explore these facets of myself, I nurture more self-acceptance and curiosity that challenges heteronormativity. And that's all my little guys. Thanks for tuning in. This is Buppy Dogs. Bye-bye.
My name is Liz. I'm an author illustrator and I am tabling at the SAD Virtual Zen and Craft Fair. I am a white cis female with dark curly brown hair that is pulled up into a messy bun and an undercut. I am wearing a gray sweatshirt with a skull on the side, with oversized clear glasses, a silver chain necklace, and a nose ring. I am sitting in a fabric lawn chair outside with the image of the forest in the background with a picket fence. In this video, I wanted to take the time to chat with you about myself, my art, my processes, and even my inspirations. I always wanted to be an artist and writer for as long as I could remember, but the journey to actually getting to this point was a hard one, mostly because I could envision the destination, but was very confused as to actually how to get to that point. After a lot of encouragement, lots of trial and error, and after even 60 manuscript rejections from potential agents, I ended up taking the leap as of summer 2020 and opened Pink Pomegranate Books. Since then, I have been publishing about a book a year since. When crafting my books, I always like to start with pencil and paper before ultimately transferring the sketch to Procreate, where I finish everything up, like outlining and then coloring. I found that I really like working with digital files, especially when it comes to my books, mainly because they're easier to edit and then transfer files into programs like Affinity Publisher, where I ultimately piece the book together. For a while for my illustrations and stickers though, I was really into keeping things digital, but sometime around last year, I kind of found myself exploring traditional mediums again, and since then have been pretty much sticking to those forms. I really love playing with a mix of mediums, specifically watercolor, gouache, ink, paint markers, and colored pencils. I do very much blame my ADHD on my inability to be able to like pick and actually stick with the medium. Much of my inspiration for my art and stories though come from folklore, nature, and my obsession with Halloween. I was not allowed to celebrate Halloween as a kid, so I think that ultimately fueled my love for it as an adult. My first official storied picture book is called Mothman and the Halloween Parade, which was published in 2022. It tells the story of Mothman, who is new to Spookyville and is trying to find a way to help his new friends prepare for the Halloween parade. It was an exciting project for me because not only did I get to draw a lot of really cool characters, but I got to highlight personal favorite cryptids. My second picture book, however, coming at the end of this year, is also set around Halloween. So it's definitely hard to deny that Halloween is not intertwined in my work. Even in my newest coloring book, you'll find Halloween references as I talk about the folklore behind the turnip, which was like the OG jack-o'-lantern before the pumpkin kind of became the Halloween king. But when I'm not coming up with like new Halloween stories, I'm always digging up new folklore tales to learn about. Much of my illustrations and stickers are inspired by folklore. My grandfather was Romanian, and my ancestry kind of fuels a lot of that love as I seek to kind of reconnect to that part of myself and the past through stories, beliefs, and customs. It's also just a reminder that the world is honestly like really magical. It stretches our understanding of the world, people, and kind of really fuels our imagination. For example, a bluebell simply isn't just a flower, but can be home to the fae. One tale says that if you can flip it inside out without tearing a petal, your true love will ultimately find you. And that just kind of makes everything more enchanting. I got a chance to really put that interest together in my book this year. I released my second coloring book this June, which was called A Folklore Coloring Book, where each page has an illustration and then a corresponding like blurb talking about the story or the folklore behind each image. It's more of a dip your toes in kind of book. I didn't really go in depth in any particular subject, but really the hope was that to spark interest, and then if something was particularly inspiring to the reader, that they could ultimately go and look more in depth into the subject later. My poetry, however, is more especially inspired, or rather deeply influenced, by my struggles with anxiety, depression, and childhood trauma. The Midnight Book was actually my first self-published piece, and a collection of 32 poems and tales, each with a corresponding illustration. Throughout the book, it's a heavy theme of the night, as I find that my biggest mental struggles kind of arise in the dark. The irony in this is that I also feel like the night is when my imagination is most active. So this book, in a sense, is like a dance between my world of fantasy as well as personal demons. It was released in December 2020, and honestly, to this day, is still one of my absolute favorite works. And I think that it's because the book literally came from my heart. Honestly, I can't thank you guys enough for listening to my little ramblings, and thank you so much to the SAD staff for letting me be a part of this. If you would like to follow along on my little art journey, you can find me most places at The Pomegranate Kid. I'm so excited, and I hope everyone has a wonderful time.
My name is Chio Ortiz Chavarria, tabling for Que Chido Chio. I'm a brown non-binary person with black curly hair in the style of a mullet. I'm wearing white earbuds, a black t-shirt, glasses. I'm currently sitting in my chair in my room slash studio space. Behind me is various artworks, either by me or other artists, friends. Includes paintings, digital art, or printmaking pieces. There's also a TV right behind me. I'm a queer and neurodivergent artist from the Pacific Northwest, and I'm grateful for the opportunity to be part of this year's Sick and Disabled Fair. Que Chido Chio translates to How Cool Chio. Chido is a common slang in Mexico to describe something that's good, amazing, or like cool. Que Chido has always been one of my favorite phrases in Spanish, and it's part of who I am, and it sounds really cool with my name. My branding is Que Chido Chio, How Cool Chio. I've been drawing and making art for as long as I can remember, but not always. My art journey has taken multiple ups and downs due to life circumstances and not always having the energy to create, which I'm sure many of you can understand. I had stopped making art for about 5 years since I went to college, and it was extremely exhausting mentally, emotionally, and physically. In those years, I learned about my ADHD, received a diagnosis, and understood why I was having a hard time in school. At the same time, stress and working in the service industry was slowly destroying my back and led to an emergency back surgery where I ended up with permanent nerve damage and chronic back pain. I completely forgot and left behind the joy of art making. And so then a few years after my surgery, I decided that nothing, anyone, especially myself, was going to get in the way of making arts anymore. Making art is truly what brings me joy and stimulates my brain. It helps me relieve stress, and it's how I wish to spend the rest of my life. Now I've been able to share art with my friends, with family, online, at fairs, and now at the Sick and Disabled Fair. So thank you again to SAD for this opportunity. I'm excited to share some of my artwork, and I hope you can connect with some of them. I am now showing a shot of my table with a yellow tablecloth, along with various prints I will be describing. One of the newer mediums I've been exploring is printmaking. During my last year in school, I took my one and last art class, which was Intro to Printmaking. It was what inspired me to create again. What I love about printmaking is the multiple day process. It involves the design making, the carving, inking, and then finally printing. Here are some of my prints. I love including creatures in my art, one of my favorites being butterflies. So here I have Monarca Mortal. It features a skull along with monarch butterfly wings. This is a four-layer reduction print. So I used the same block to print every single layer, starting from the lightest color to the darkest. Because the block will never have the original shape of the first print, I won't be able to recreate these ever again. So this print has 15 copies, and only 15 of them will ever exist. But I also have one layer prints, which I am able to recreate. So for example, these ones I originally created in black ink, but because my art style is a lot more colorful, I decided to recreate them with like ombre colors. So this first print right here is inspired by the Fool tarot card. It features a butterfly flying in the sun after it left its cocoon. And then this one over here with a much more simple butterfly design is what would represent the back of the tarot card if this was a full set. Both prints are available in these ombres that go from a like dark blue to a purple to a more magenta color. Lastly, I have jaguars surrounded by monsteras. These are also available in ombres. So I have this one that's warm toned and then this one that's cool toned. All these prints are hand numbered and signed since they are technically originals. And then the prices of all these prints are determined by the layers, the number of colors used in each print, the size of it, the quality of the paper, as long with how many prints are in each edition. So for example, these jaguar ones, each color, the warm and the cool tone, only have 10 each. And then the ones I just showed you about the tarot only have 5 each, and then the skull monarch only has 15 each. Next, I would love to talk about a medium that made me fall in love with art making, painting. I mostly explore acrylic and watercolor. One of my goals in life is to create as many butterflies in all the different forms of art making and have a wall full of butterflies. I just find them so beautiful and inspiring. And I love to be inspired by their shapes and their colors. I have original paintings of this red peacock butterfly. It has some pretty cool sides. And then original painting of this swallowtail, also with some pretty cool sides. They are 6 by 6 inches. I also know original paintings can be a little expensive. So what I like to do as well is have photocopy versions of them. It might not have the sides, but it does have that front part. Here's that red peacock. And then I scan, adjust color, pick out paper, and print it all myself. And that's just to make sure that these photocopy prints are as close to the original colors of the original paintings. Next, I want to share some of my watercolor paintings, which are kind of mixed media paintings. So I have this turtle that's swimming in the moonlight. It's swimming directly behind the moon, along with like a starry night. I love the water and the ocean. I personally try to visit the beach at least once a month to calm down my nervous system. This piece is technically mixed media due to the black and white line work that you see that I used Macron and a Posca pen for. Another ocean-inspired painting is this jellyfish painting I have. It's also technically mixed media. It's mostly watercolor. So it features this jellyfish with an eyeball in its middle. It's looking down toward this other creature that has like tentacles with eyeballs on it. But yes, it's mostly watercolor. It has some marker, so like these more saturated colors are marker, along again with Micron and Posca pen. And then lastly, I have this watercolor painting that was commissioned for a friend. They wanted some cover art for their newest single. The song is about long-distance queer love, how special it is to share experiences together and not wanting them to end. The main chorus line is, "It's so special being an angel." Their lyrics inspired this illustration of two angel silhouettes reaching out for each other. The background includes like a psychedelic sunset, a planet, mushrooms, and butterflies. And then the colors are meant to be both happy and sad, kind of like, you know, bittersweet. Sometimes like things have to end, or sometimes you just don't want experiences to end. So that's why I use the contrasting between cool tones and warm tone to kind of like represent that, like, you know, this was a really good experience, but I'm also sad that it's ending soon or coming to an end. And then next, I wanted to share some other options to purchase my artwork. I also have stickers, such as this queer sticker with a psychedelic like rainbow, sun, some bees on there. I have this pink and yellow jaguar head. And I also have some stickers that say, "All my homies love the earth," "All my homies hate capitalism," and "All my homies hate colonialism." I also have various magnets of like my artwork I just showed you. So for example, I have the butterflies as magnets, multiple butterflies. I have that sunset angel one as a magnet. And I also have some other designs that are in magnet form. With that, all of that being said, I do want to say thank you for taking the time to look through my artwork, to get to know me and to know my craft. Shipping expenses are included in the pricing for USA shipping only. I am open to shipping to Mexico or Canada, but I ask you that you please inquire with me first before ordering to determine the shipping costs. Just because it really depends on like the size of the weight. Like, let's say you want to order like one of the original paintings, but you live in Mexico or Canada. That's going to really differentiate the pricing. So I would like to know before what items you're interested in. I hope you check out my virtual booth. And if you have any questions, comments, want to know more about my art, please feel free to contact me. My virtual booth will have my contact information. So yeah, please reach out. Thank you. Bye.
Don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I'd like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6'2" in a compact, no slack. But luckily the seats go back. I got a knack to relax in my mind. I'm sipping some red, red wine. I sip brews from China.
I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch. Yeah. She keep that booty, booty. She keep that plump. Yeah. That natural beauty, beauty. Yeah, yeah. If you could see it from the front, we tell you see it from the back. Back, 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 juicy. Back, back, yeah. Back, 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 juicy. Back, 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 juicy. If you could see it from the front, we tell you see it from the back. Yeah. He like it thick, he like it fat. Yeah. Like to keep him wanting more. From the back, 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 juicy. Back, back, yeah, back, back.
I'm Val. I'm a butch trans woman with long hair, long purple hair, and an undercut. I've got glasses on and a gray tank top with a brown leather bulldog harness and a pair of jeans on. I'm here in my workshop with a pegboard behind me with all sorts of leather working tools behind me. And right next to me is a mannequin with a couple of harnesses that I'm going to tell you about in a little bit. My shop is called Violet Leather Co. I make leather kink gear for all different bodies, regardless of size, ability, gender. I try to make everything as inclusive and accessible as I can. One of my favorite kinds of products to make is floggers like this one. This one's a pretty basic design. This is a good starting point if you're new to using floggers or if you want kind of a basic everyday one to use. It's just a pretty simple black leather one. The falls are loose. It's heavy, it can pack a punch, but it's not the most intense thing ever. If you want a bit of a step up, this one is basically the same thing, except the falls are braided. That kind of concentrates the impact a little bit more and gives it a little bit more of a sting. If stingy is less your thing and you want something more thuddy, this heavy flogger might be more for you. You can even hear the difference in the sound there. This is like the first one I showed you, but made with a much heavier leather, so it kind of packs more of a punch. It spreads out the impact a bit, and it gives you a little more thuddy of a feeling. The last impact toy I want to show you is a slapper. This is made to be kind of like a belt folded up if you're using it on someone. That's got a nice sting to it too. All very fun. So besides floggers, another kind of product that I like to make is collars like this. This one is the chainmail lace collar. It's basically just a simple leather band with chainmail hanging down from it. It's a little bit more of a decorative one. I've got another one kind of like it that's just long strings of chain hanging down. I've also got some other ones that are a little more minimalistic, a little more practical, that can take a little bit more heavy play. Those are more of just a simple O-ring in the front. Along with collars, another main product that we make is harnesses like this one or the one I'm wearing. This bikini shaped one is called the Anu harness. This one's a little more butch. This one's a classic bulldog design. And this one down here is the Castina line. I have a hip harness version of it that's just kind of a strap that goes between your legs. And I also have a strap-on version that you can put a toy into and use it for play like that. That version is very strappy and looks very good on bigger bodies. A couple last kinds of products that I offer are wrist and ankle cuffs like these ones. They're just a simple basic leather designed to keep your wrists and your ankles together. I also make belts like this one I'm wearing right now. I've worn this every day for the last 2 years, just about, and it has held up perfectly. So most of these products are available in ready-to-ship versions, but in the spirit of inclusivity and accessibility, I have a big focus in my shop on making made-to-order products. For that, I take, you send me your measurements and any kind of concerns you have about fit, accessibility, anything like that, and I will do everything that I can to make a product that's going to fit you perfectly and that's going to be as usable, as accessible as possible for you. That can include all kinds of different fit adjustments, different kinds of constructions for different potential disabilities and things like that. It can also include a wide variety of different leather colors and a couple of different options for different metals for the hardware. Thanks for taking the time to listen. Again, I'm Val from Violet Leather Co. I hope you get a chance to check out my shop. And